Right, I think we're good to go. Let's make it happen. Time to go for a bit of a blast, hey? To go. Okay, time to rock on out of here for now. Got a new Purple Panda mic. I'm trying out the new microphone. I just hate having to try the mic setup though, because there's so much cable and you got to tuck it in somewhere. And I mean, if I have a look in the mirror now, I've probably got cables hanging out all over the place. But I'm hoping this improves some of the audio quality. I'm really looking forward to that. This is Scenic Drive in Newcastle. Some cracking ocean views. I don't want to get too tied up in the traffic. I just want to take a bit of a scenic run, because due lockdown, this is as far as it's going to get. One of the things you're allowed to do is inspect property, so I'm going to do just that. Something I'm starting to realise in lockdown is regret. A hell of a lot of regret. Regret that I didn't get out when I had the opportunity to. Regret that I haven't caught up with mates when I had that opportunity. Lots of regret. Look at that view. Oh, big offshorey. That's cracking. Let's go and have a look at the ocean. I might have to adjust the GoPro a little bit. So yeah, I've been filled with a fair amount of regret, because I haven't really been getting out there and doing things that I wanted to do. I've been blatantly, and I'll own it, been blatantly lazy, which is a bit poor of me, to be honest. Oh, a bit of a swell running too, look at that. Hey, there'll be a few of them out today. We'll do a scoot by and go and have a checkers. Nice. So I really need to pull the finger out and get out some, and go and explore a little bit more, go and have a little bit more fun, do some more filming, and start putting the stuff that I film up on the channel. I've done a few videos, I've gone out, done some recording, and I just haven't uploaded it, because I've been looking at it going, yeah, your YouTube content's a bit ordinary. I'm a bit hard on myself like that. Even when I did the showy helmet, the GT Air 2 long-term opinion, because I don't like reviews. Don't know why I don't like using that word. But the long-term chat about the helmet, got the sound all sorted out, that's good. Got the camera there, it was a little bit dark. And like I said, the house is a bit of a mess because we're moving out. But I just threw it up there and I thought, nah, don't second guess, just get it up there and tell people your thoughts. So I did, just left it there. If you've had a look at it, thanks for that. Yeah, so I need to really pull the finger out and get out some more, and muck around a little bit, get out some rides, do some more filming, put that video online and start building that channel up. Coming right into the center of Newcastle now, I'm gonna make sure the camera's still recording. I thought I'd press the button there, but I haven't, so that's not a bad thing. Gonna have to battery change on the way up to the house. Look at that, there's a view. Newcastle Beach. Stunning day, bit of wind around, nice big offshore. Yeah. However, I'm going to go all the way down through the centre here. We'll go through the middle of Nui. Do love this town. And then we'll get the hell out of the traffic-filled locality. Yeah, so I've been speaking quite a lot about things that I'm going to be doing, and I am a planner. I like to plan things. It helps me pass the time. Pardon me for the nod. Legend. So I can't see my indicator light because the camera's in the way. I'm going to fix that, but that's a tomorrow problem. So yeah, a bit of a planner. One of the reasons I love to plan is because it gives me a goal. And in these times, you need some goals to get out and, you know, have something to focus on, have something to aim for. I recommend it. I suggest it. My wife doesn't like me planning because she thinks it involves spending money. No word of a lie, it certainly does. And I have been planning on selling the GS. It's already advertised. I've spoken to some dealers, had a chat with the guys down at Fraser's. Good to see Harry's is open. Spoke to the guys at Fraser's, maybe a trade-in, but I'm going to see if I can flog it off privately. Got to get her in for a service, there's a few things I need fixed up. A common thing with some of the GS's, if you're in first gear, even with your clutch in, you can't start it. There's a screw under here that I need to muck around with so that the sensor realizes that the clutch is in while you're in first and it lets you start. So it won't let me do that at the moment. Get that sorted out. Get her a service. I've still got the road touring tires on it. And she's coming up for 110,000 K. Let's have a look. Yeah, 109,352 is what I got on it. Basically said I've got 110K on it, just in case I do a couple of rides up to the property and back. So it's advertised, looking at a couple of bikes. The must-haves, I'd like to have more than 20 litres. So, you know, the GSAs have been one to look at with the a 30 litre tank, you know, and I've loved the GS, loved the Beamer. But there's several bikes on the market, adventure bikes, with bigger tanks. And I'm certainly going to consider those as well. But I can't take anything for a ride at the moment, so I'm kind of stuck. Kind of stuck sitting around waiting, so I just plan. I've been on bike sales, checking out all kinds of stuff to see if there's anything that's worthwhile getting into. But yeah, until I take one for a ride, the only downside with taking bikes for a ride is when I took that the KTM for a run, and another, well, the KTM was the RS, the 1250 RS. So I took those two bikes for a run and I got back on the GS and I was like, God, I love this bike. So, you know, I still keep coming back to that. So I am looking at another adventure bike. It's going to be a little bit more off-road orientated. I'm not saying the GS isn't off-road. I do, you know, I'll still end up doing, I think, 70% road touring. But if I can, I'll probably cut that down a bit. There's some tracks out at the Wadigans that I'm absolutely hanging out to go and explore. And like I said, Gloucester Tops, Barrington's, all that beautiful area up there. And that's going to be my backyard when we move into the new house. So the aim of the game there will be to have some access to tracks. And it's not going to be a single track, like, you know, get out in your DRZ650 or any of those. It's going to be packed gravel, limestone, places I can throw some camping gear on the back, go and do an overnight somewhere on a couple of days off, and go and explore some different areas. Go and catch up with Simon from Global Walkabout or Steve from Big Bike Adventures. I'm hanging out to catch up with Vern from Motor Rides Australia, Brent Pearson. So all these lads that are getting out and doing a bit of off-road stuff, I'm absolutely hanging out to go and do that. So yeah, there's a fair bit there that I want to do, and it all involves getting a little bit off-road. There is absolutely nothing wrong with the GS, but I'm just keeping my options open. That's the plan. So it's advertised, and then as I take a few bikes out, I'll be sure to let you guys know and start getting some more stuff lined up on the channel. God, I hate being stuck in traffic. It's 25 degrees, it's beautiful. But I'm feeling a little bit toasty on the inside. Let's get out of here. Oh, get some airflow. Alright, how's the camera looking? Yep. That's not bad. I don't know what's happened. Usually I only get about 40 minutes of footage out of the camera. But by the looks of it there, 44 minutes and 24 seconds with, it looks like probably 20%, maybe 25% battery left. Not going to argue with that. Oh, I hear something. Or is it the wind? It's probably the bloody wind. Alright. Oh yeah, there's something. Something on final now. So why don't we go and have a look? That looks like a larger aircraft though. Yeah, that'll be a larger aircraft. We'll just park it up here for a moment. The wedge tail, bloody nice. Oh, you know what I should have done? Should have lined up a photo. What a way to go. Hey, how's that? Oh, up he goes again, going around. Well, why don't we stick around then, and I might try and do a bit of a photo. Yeah. Oh no, it's a hawk that's coming out there. That's not bad. So, little hawk coming out to do a bit of a run. And I don't think there's anything else here coming in, by the looks of it. Alright. Well, I might try and line it up so I can get a photo of the wedge tail in the background of the bike. I think that'd be bloody lovely. Yeah, it looks good. All right, time to go. Okay, let's head on up. This battery's gonna die shortly, so we'll just get on the straight and narrow, and away we go. Beauty.